I think it might be useful for you to understand what different setups of blended vision might be beneficial and what typical setups a blended vision may help. Hi there! My name is Oleksii and you're at the IOL-adviser channel telling the truth about IOLs. First of all, blended vision may help in terms of aid of lenses of different manufacturers, because if you're talking about presbyopia correcting lenses of different manufacturers, different aid of lenses in presbyopia correcting segment may have a different near vision quality, near vision quantity, and different night vision quality. For instance, I had an example a few years ago. I had a consultation with a patient who was unhappy with a vivity because he had a lack of vision in shadows during his night driving. He was absolutely unhappy and sad because he was not able to see details in the shadows when he was driving, and he was using his right eye even with a cataract, which gives him a better vision. I have admitted to that patient had some problems with retina, pre-existing clinical conditions, and VVT in that case was not the best lens for him, but for whatever reason it has been chosen. And we decided to try and to discuss with his doctor option to go with a Symphony or other lens. And he ended up with a good night vision when he added a Symphony, because that lens provided a better night vision, a better contrast. So it's one of the cases when the quantity of vision was okay for them. I'm talking about I'm talking about the near vision reading ability, but the quality of night vision was not satisfactory. And in that case scenario, it was possible to use even a monofocal to increase the amount of light depending on clinical conditions, or other aid of lens which will provide more contrast to that particular patient with a pre-existing retinal problems. So the safest and the most, let's say, widely used combination of blended vision, it might be enhanced monofocal and presbyopia correcting lenses, which are based on aid of type, in case if extended monofocal is not providing fair enough near vision, which is absolutely expected. But you know, the problem is that sometimes patients are not really perceive and understand, and even myself, I have no idea how I will tolerate my near vision if I will be using a lens like Eyhance, if I will decide to do so, in terms of near vision. Because in my case, I have a high hyperopia and probably I will have a better depth of field than expected. But in vast majority of cases, patient may underestimate the visual experience, because vision is absolutely subjective, and it's one of the reasons, and the main reason, when I'm talking to you in my previous video, by the way, that using someone's else experience, asking what type of lens do you have, if you have one, I have the lens A, B, or C, doesn't matter. And are you happy? Yeah, totally, absolutely fine. The problem is that my fine or your fine or somebody else fine is could be absolutely wrong or terrible for you or for me. You can use my free version of AI IOL selection assistant and my website, which will help you to understand better your visual needs, understand different IOL options, guide you to different compromises associated with different IOLs, and will help you to be prepared better for final discussion with your surgeon, including all the knowledge I have. Details are in the description below. So, if somebody implanted them kind of enhanced monofocal or standard monofocal, which is, I think, the worst case scenario today to use a standard monofocal, just unless you have a clinical pre-existing conditions which will give you just monofocal option. So it's about the depth of field and visual acuity at near or intermediate. In that case, for instance, we can combine extended monofocal like Eyhance or BNL Aspiro or whatever, doesn't matter, with some kind of with some kind of presbyopia correcting aid of lens, which will give you a better near, which will add near to this pre-existing enhanced monofocal and will give you fairly good balance. Of course, as I mentioned earlier, it's better to implant bilaterally presbyopia correcting extended depth of focus lenses. But sometimes it's not the case for various reasons. Well, second option, it might be an option when somebody implanted a trifocal or full range of vision diffractive lens in one eye, and this person is unhappy with halos, glare, and night driving. or it might include as well contrast sensitivity. In that case scenario, we can use enhanced monofocal just to give you better night driving, to reduce halo glare from second eye, and your brain will adapt somehow to improve that condition. Or it could be extended monofocal or EDOF based non-diffractive presbyopia correcting increased range of vision lens. What else? Monofocal plus extended monofocal or presbyopia correcting non-diffractive EDOF lens is the best combination if you just, for whatever reason, had one eye implanted with a monofocal. So honestly, we have more than 10 combinations of different blended vision approaches, including the different refractive targets, which is moving us to a monovision or mini or micro monovision setups. And well, it will be too long to discuss during this video. So if you like this video, if you like my channel, please subscribe now. And I will be grateful if you will give me some comments about your particular experience with your IOLs, or if you just give me any comment to that video just to support my work on YouTube. Thank you for watching and see you next videos. Bye.